Hi all, this tutorial continues from my previous guide on setting up reverse proxy using Microsoft IIS. Here we will cover the process of installing free SSL from Let's Encrypt in Microsoft IIS. Please be aware that this guide is for educational purposes only and should not be applied in a production environment. In a development setting, ensuring the security of the environment becomes essential, particularly for integration with other services that uses SSL and for testing advanced functionality such as push notifications. The implementation process involves leveraging a third-party software called WinACME. Step 1. Get WinACME. It is a tool that helps you get SSL certificate easily. Step 2. Set up your website in IIS. Step 3. Requesting SSL certificates from Let's Encrypt using WinACME tool. Follow along as we make our development environment safer in just a few simple steps. Let's download and install WinACME. Open a browser and search for WinACME. You can directly go to WinACME website or you can open the GitHub page and from there you can navigate to WinACME website. From the download section, download the latest version. Once the download is completed, go to the download folder and let's unzip WinACME. Right click and run as administrator. You may get a warning, however you can ignore this warning. Click run anyway. As you are requesting a new certificate, enter N and press enter. You may get this error as we have not configured the bindings in IIS manager. Let's open the server manager and configure the binding. Go to your website and on the right side under edit site click bindings. Edit and enter the host name and click OK. Binding for HTTPS is not required. This will be automatically configured like once you install SSL certificate using WinACME. You can close this, go back to the WinACME console and then start the process again. This time it will detect the website configured in IIS. And you can follow the on-screen instruction to complete the SSL installation. Provide basic information to request the SSL. Go back to the browser and load your website. We can see that your website is now secured with an SSL. We have to complete one more step, that is configuring trusted origins in ORDS configuration file. After completing the basic settings, if you log into Oracle Apex Workspace, you may get this error. To overcome this, we need to configure the trusted origin in ORDS settings file. Open the settings file and add two entries, one for the domain and second to force HTTPS request. This is particularly required when you are running ORDS behind a reverse proxy. Save the settings file and restart the ORDS server. Once the server is restarted, you can successfully log into Oracle Apex Workspace without any errors. By following the steps outlined in this tutorial and configuring trusted origins, we can establish a secure foundation for testing and integrating advanced functionalities into our Oracle Apex applications. Thank you for watching.